she was a little tough, you know. I wasn't always taller than us, you know, she was always bigger than me.
When you hear her talk and you hear her tell her story, which she doesn't just always talk about, it's just amazing that she's come out on the side that she's come out on.
Her game has grown tremendously to the point where she came to us as a 3-4. She's going to college as a 1-2.
Same thing with basketball. I'd say she started like around, I don't even know, third, fourth grade. She has just always loved basketball. Like she used to watch, you know, some of the women play, some of the men play. She has just always loved basketball.
And yeah, we do kind of like look at that as in, you know, we're doing what our mom used to do. So it kind of like, you know, runs in our blood, spiritually like that, I guess.
But in 2011, just 2 days after returning home from a state championship game, Aisha and Marvin received the news that would change their lives forever.
They called me down to the office, and while I was heading down to the office, I passed by my coach, and my coach was like, Aisha, did you hear something happened to your mom? She in the hospital. My brother and my uncle came to pick us up. And they took us home. They told us she passed away. I couldn't believe it at all. It was so shocking. Like, I packed all my things and I just left the house. I couldn't believe it at all.
I know that she's gone, but I know deep down inside that she's really not gone. And from then on, things just started getting worse and worse and worse. During that time, people started to take advantage of me and my brother. I was staying with my brother, but it was so many things going on that he wasn't like functioning well with everything. So he lost my mom's house, he lost her car, everything. Then it was one day he told us that we would have to stay with friends until he find a place for all of us to stay.
I met Aisha officially October of 2010, but I've known her mom since she was about seventh grade. We used to talk on the phone at least once or twice a year just to see how things were going. And then going into her 10th grade year, she started looking for a different team to play with. So she came to a couple of camps that we were hosting and had a great time and met the girls, enjoyed the girls, and got to know the program. So just throughout everything, we were just kind of feeling each other out. Never really talked to her that much. Did most of the talking with mom and her trainer. And after the funeral, we met and we talked, and I told her and her trainer, I said, whatever you decide, we're good with. As a program, we're here to support you. We're here to help with the brother. If she needs to go, he needs to go. We'll make arrangements no matter where we are. We went out to California. We made sure he came. He had that opportunity to come. So he traveled with us. But whatever you decide to do, I'm not sure if hanging up basketball is the answer. Because right now, this may be the only thing that can help you get through this. So throughout that process, she would just tell me, like, Coach Kim, we can't stay with where we're staying. I said, what do you mean? Your brother's gonna take care of you? And she kept telling me, well, Aisha, whenever you decide, our home is there for you. Whenever you and Marvin decide, put them back on a bus. They called me about an hour or two later and said, we wanna come. So from November to November, finally, 12-month process, the adoption was finally finalized. And she said, Coach Kim, once we get to Tallahassee, I just think my game is gonna soar. And I was like, you think? She's like, I don't know, I just have this feeling it's just gonna soar.
First time I found out she was going to Florida High was the first day of school. This year, I was out in the parking lot and doing car duty on the first day of school, and I saw Coach Kim come up, and I was trying to figure out why she was here, what she was doing at Florida High. And that's when she said, well, Aisha's coming to school here. And so I was really excited about that because I had heard, you know, a lot about her and what she could do on the basketball court.
I thought she was going to be a cocky player. I thought she was just kind of going to treat us like, oh, okay, they don't know what they're doing, but I'm going to do my own thing.
She was ranked so high, and I was like, oh my gosh, I don't think I want to play because I don't want to play with anyone that's going to have a cocky attitude. Like, I'm the best.
But Aisha is the exact opposite. I know Aisha actually has worked with me and enhancing my skills on the basketball court. And I've seen her during practice. She'll work with some of our post players. She'll also work with our guards to better them because she knows that she's only here for a year. And she knew that she wanted to better Florida High girls basketball team, not just this year, but also in the future.
I expected her to come in and make an impact, obviously, with us, but the player that we got, I think, was a whole lot more than what I could have imagined. Tired of living day to day like everything's all right. Every night just one thing on my mind. I'm just waiting on that moment. Waiting on my moment. You say, oh, you got that all shit. Hell no, next time that's mine. But as long as I stay hustling, I'm gonna shine. Just waiting on that moment.
Coming into Florida High, it was kind of nerve-wracking because I'm coming in a new city, a new place, a new school. It was like I have to meet new people. I was nervous, didn't you know what. But when the season started, we got into conditioning. The girls brought me in as their family, like I'd known them for a while. But the two who I really connected with was Ori and Ben.
Aisha is a friend that's there for you, regardless of what you're going through. I know she's the type of person where when I see her, it's kind of like we're always laughing or we're smiling.
She's gonna be there for you. She's gonna give you good advice. She's never gonna let you down.
I remember asking her, how does she deal with her mom passing and everything, because on her way to Chipotle, I got a call from my mom, but she was telling me she was in the hospital. So I immediately started crying because I didn't know what to do. Aisha was like, Deanne, just calm down. Everything's gonna be okay. I've been through the same thing. And right then, that's why I knew I had the right person to confide in, because she had been through what I was going through right then. I felt that's when we really connected, that day before the game.
On the court, everything is positive. Off the court, everything is positive with her. She never has a negative attitude. I've played without her a couple years on the basketball team, and without her, the team is pretty good. But with her, she's motivated me, and I'm pretty sure she's motivated other players on the team to just push and to strive.
They really stuck with me from the beginning of the season to the end of the season, and after the season, we still talk and hang out outside of school and outside of basketball. I felt like those were true friends because it wasn't just basketball and our friendship, it was also me as a person.
It's amazing to see what those two young people have had to overcome and are coming out on the other side of it. I'd always heard about people who had had the privilege of coaching All-Americans, and I never thought that I would be given the opportunity to have an All-American, but it was such a blessing to be able to coach her and to just watch her develop and to the person that she is becoming.
What she's doing it for her mom. She's not gonna stop striving for her success. She's gonna succeed. She's, like she said, she does it for her mom. She's doing it for her. Gotta give the fans what they want, as Aisha say.
And she's gonna sign with Baylor, one of the premier women's basketball programs in the country. And I mean, it's just, I think that's just showing you what happens when you work hard. Nothing's been handed to her. She's had to work for everything on and off the basketball court. And I think she's just living proof of what can happen when you work hard.
When you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. I don't know how many of y'all got asthma here today, but if you ever had an asthma attack before, you short of breath, SOB, shortness of breath, you wheezing. The only thing you're trying to do is get some air. You don't care about no basketball game. You don't care what's on TV. You don't care about nobody calling you. You don't care about a party. The only thing you care about when you're trying to breathe is to get some fresh air. That's it. And when you get to the point where all you want to do is be successful, as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
I think it's a wonderful decision. I feel like she will have a family stability there, like, because she knows two or three of the players that's already there. And plus, when she get there, that's just gonna, like, basically the whole, all four of them there. They're gonna have that sisterhood.
I am a tall tree, oh, I am a swift wind, sweeping the country. I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am,
okay. Young man down there with the
just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest.
It was a very hard decision because I was in love with Baylor and South Carolina. I love Kim Mulkey and I love Coach Davis. But it really came down to who I felt where I was going to be comfortable at in a better situation for me. Knowing in the past 3 years, I know that I've been moving from different place to place. And I just wanted to settle down and finally make a decision that was best for me. And as for me being comfortable, and I thought Baylor was the place because I know so many people there. I have family there. It's like, I just thought it was a better fit for me, so.
You taught me everything, everything you've given me. I always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. Oh, you were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me.